Morning children, today we will revise poem number 3 from your reader book and then we will do the comprehension exercise for the same. So in this poem we read that there was a fairy and she went to the zoo and usne zoo mein kya dekha ki there are many animals but they are all caged. Okay, there are few things to remember in this poem. I'm revising it so that sabko sab cheeze clear ho jaye. Few people did not watch the last video, that is why I'm sending it again. हमने ये देखा that she was a very sweet fairy and she went to the zoo. She paid shilling bit. Shilling bit means very small amount of money. Alright? Then they had let her through the gate inside the zoo so that she can see what is inside. She saw and she visited and she saw that all the beast here refer to animals. Okay, she saw that all the beasts were caged within the grounds. You know, they were all caged within the ground. The largest and the least. यहाँ पे मतलब है the largest, for example, lion, you know, elephant, tiger, the most powerful and the biggest, and the least. यानी कि सबसे बड़े से लेकर सबसे छोटे तक they all were caged. Least means the smallest. Okay, she saw the wolves pace up and down inside their cage. Now, she saw that all the animals are uncomfortable and they're all wanting to get out of their cages. Okay, and the monkeys, they laughed. Firstly, they laughed and then they had rage. Rage means anger. They wanted to come out again because as you can see here, it's a small cage. The monkey wants to come out. Okay. She saw the lion. As we all know that lion is very ferocious and he's very, you know, powerful. He's always running. He's a very fast runner and all of that. But beside all of his qualities, he was just sitting there inside the cage as if, and you know, he was not giving any reaction to all the people who were standing outside their cage. So the fairy here says that he was as still as if there is no one outside his cage. Okay. He was so used to all those people coming and he was, you know, so sad and so, you know, traumatized by his cage that he was just sitting there. He was not even like a living body. He was just like almost dead. Okay. So he was staring outside the crowd outside the cage and he was behaving as if there is no one outside the cage. Now come to the next page. We saw that the fairy found a seat and she had ordered tea and buns. Lekin jo wo tea and buns leke aati hai waitress, though they are the nicest ones. Okay, just a second. Yeah. Though they are the nicest ones, but she could not eat one bit. Bit here means one piece or one bite. Alright, you can see here down in the new words. Then she says ki, oh dear, the fairy sobbed. Sob ka matlab hota hai to cry. Okay, sobbed yahan pe past tense mein likha hai, isliye sobbed hai, sobbed. Then the fairy says, oh dear, the fairy sobbed, yani ki usne rote rote kaha, I wish those beasts were free. Un jo beast unhone dekha fairy ne zoo mein, she was so sad about it. She was feeling so much about them. She could actually feel how all those beasts or the animals must be feeling inside their cages, that she could not eat even a single bite of the bun that she had ordered, and she could not drink the tea that she had ordered and what the waitress had come with, because she was very sad about the state of animals which she saw at the zoo. So children, the poet here doesn't want to tell you what fairies actually saw. The poet wants to tell you that we should not cage animals. We should not treat animals as non-living things or as if they do not have emotions. Animals ke paas bhi life hai, emotions hai, unko bhi feelings hain. Wo bhi hamari feelings samajh sakte hain. That is why jaise humko cage mein rehna pasand nahi aayega shayad, to unko bhi pasand nahi aayega. Okay, so we all should never ever ever cage an animal and we should you know I should say that we should stop going to the zoo also. If you want to see animals, you can go on internet, you can watch any video or something like that. Or maybe go to a wildlife sanctuary where all the animals are there. You know, for example, we have Corbett National Park, jahan pe Tigers Reserve hai. You can go visit Tiger National Parks, bird sanctuaries are there. You can go such places and see birds and animals who are living in such a place which is free for them. You know, when you go to a live sanctuary, wildlife sanctuary, you are put in a cage and then you are allowed to, you know, go through the wildlife sanctuary through a vehicle. Animals are not caged. Alright, so we should try and go to wildlife sanctuaries where, you know, animals are living in much better and free conditions than the zoos where animals are put in small cages and the situations, conditions are very uncomfortable and bad. Alright children, now we will go to the comprehension part. And we do the comprehension now. Okay. Very small comprehension here. Where did the fairy visit? Fairy ne kahan visit kiya? Park mein gayi thi fairy. Visit ka matlab hota hai kahin jana. If I visit you, that means I have come to your place. Okay? To fairy ne kahan pe visit kiya tha? Fairyland mein visit kiya tha, beach pe kiya tha ya zoo pe kiya tha? You have to mark it and tell it to me and send it to me as homework. You have to do all these three as homework, page number 62. Alright children. Second question. Who lived in the zoo? Plants, human beings, beasts or fish? Aapko batana hai ki in charo mein se zoo mein kaun rehta tha? Lived means, live means rehna, okay? And lived means कौन रहता था यानी कि पोयम में हमने जो पढ़ा उसमें ठीक है थर्ड क्वेश्चन व्हाट वर द वुल्व्स डूइंग वुल्व्स अपने केज में क्या कर रहे थे वो अपने केज में स्विमिंग कर रहे थे सिंगिंग कर रहे थे डांसिंग कर रहे थे या फिर वॉकिंग क्विकली अप एंड डाउन या फिर वो वॉक कर रहे थे क्विकली अप एंड डाउन ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 व्हाट डिड द फेरी ऑर्डर फेरी ने क्या ऑर्डर किया था कोल्ड ड्रिंक ऑर्डर किया था सैंडविच ऑर्डर किया था चिप्स किया था या फिर टी एंड बंस किया था यू हैव इन ऑल दीज फोर पार्ट चिल्ड्रन यू हैव टू टेक द करेक्ट आंसर एंड देन राइट इट इन योर नोटबुक एंड सेंड इट टू मी एज होमवर्क ओके द पार्ट बी थिंक एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस डिड द फेरी हैड टू पे एन एंट्रेंस फी टू विजिट द जू इफ यस हाउ मच डिड शी पे Now the question is ki did the fairy have to pay an entrance fee to visit the zoo? Did the fairy have to pay? Kya fairy ko kuch pay karna pada tha to visit the zoo? Kya fairy ko ek entrance fee pay karna pada tha to visit the zoo? If yes, agar haan to kitna pay kiya usne, okay? Second one, which animals has she mentioned in the poem where the animals sorry were the animals happy or sad first question ye hai ki fairy kis kis animals jaake milti hai kaun se animals poem mein mentioned hai okay second hai were the animals happy or sad ki animals happy the ya sad the alright Third, where do you think the fairy went to have tea? Did she enjoy her tea? वो ये पूछ रहे हैं आपसे poet की fairy कहाँ गई to have tea? Tea पीने के लिए कहाँ गई? क्या उसने अपना tea enjoy किया? Did she enjoy her tea? क्या उसने अपना tea enjoy किया? Okay, fourth one, why was the fairy sad? In the last second last line we had read sobbed 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 ka basically matlab hota hai subakna jaise hum jaise aapne kabhi na kabhi roya hoga towards jab aap thoda zyada rote hain to aapko saans aana band hoti hai to aap छोटी छोटी सांसें लेना शुरू करते हैं, एंड यू आर स्टिल क्राइंग, उसको हम कहते हैं सॉबिंग, ओके, या फिर सॉब. सॉब इज द रूट वर्ड, सॉब्ड इज द पास्ट टेंस, एंड सॉबिंग SOBBING इज द प्रेजेंट टेंस एंड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूस टेंस. ओके, सो हियर गोज लाइक दिस. सो हमने देखा कि वो सॉब कर रही थी. सॉब कब करते हैं? जब रोते हैं. और कब रोते हैं? जब हम सैड होते हैं. सो वॉज द फेरी सैड? येस, शी वॉज सैड बिकॉज शी वॉज नॉट फीलिंग गुड अबाउट द स्टेट ऑफ एनिमल्स इन द जू. ओके, ये तीन आप करेंगे, मुझे और भेजेंगे होमवर्क के लिए. ऑलराइट, सी, फाइंड वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द पोएम विच मीन द सेम एज द फॉलोइंग. चिल्ड्रन, हमने पहले पढ़ा है एंटोनिम्स. ओके, एंटोनिम्स का मतलब होता है जो ऑपोजिट होते हैं. हम कैसे रखेंगे याद वर्ड को? एंटी, एंटी. ओके, एंटो, एंटी. एंटी मतलब क्या होता है? ऑपोजिट. यहाँ पे देखो, कह रहे हैं मीन द सेम एज फॉलोइंग. एंटोनिम का मतलब होता है वो एक वर्ड जो कि उस जो कि गिवन वर्ड से ऑपोजिट हो. फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर हमें सॉब का सॉब्ड का ऑपोजिट लगना होगा तो हम लिखेंगे लव्ड. ओके, क्योंकि सॉब कब करते हैं? जब रोते हैं. और जब हंसते हैं तो उसको क्या कहते हैं? लव्ड. ओके, तो ये हो जाएगा एंटोनिम. अगर हमें सॉब का सिनोनिम लिखना होगा सॉब्ड का, तो हम क्या लिखेंगे? क्राइड. यानी कि सेम, सिनोनिम, SYNONYM. सिनोनिम मतलब सेम, सेम वर्ड या फिर सिमिलर वर्ड. ओके, जहाँ पे सिनो आएगा उसको आप ऐसे ध्यान रखेंगे कि उसका मतलब होगा सेम. ठीक है, तो एंटोनिम हमारा हो गया ऑपोजिट वर्ड और सिनोनिम हमारा हो गया सेम वर्ड. अगर यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन में लिखा होता फाइंड वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द पोयम विच आर सिनोनिम्स ऑफ द फॉलोइंग, तो भी आप एग्जैक्टली वही चीज़ करते जो आप अभी इस टाइम करने वाले हैं. यानी कि आप वो वर्ड फाइंड आउट करते जिनका मतलब इसके जैसा है या इसके सेम है. ओके, सो सेम मीनिंग वाले वर्ड्स को हम क्या कहते हैं? सिनोनिम. और उल्टे मतलब वाले को हम क्या कहते हैं? एंटोनिम. ऑलराइट चिल्ड्रन, इतना ही करेंगे हम आज बस. एंड दिस इज़ योर होमवर्क कॉम्प्रिहेंशन एक्सरसाइज ऑन पेज नंबर 62 A, B, and C. You have to do this for your homework and send it to me by 12 o'clock today. Thank you so much, children.